I got a real plug, it never let me down. Always come through when I need it, never been a drought. Told my daughters count me in, they couldn't count me out.
They tried to take me down with them, took a different route.
I'm plugged in, I'm plugged in, I'm plugged in, I'm plugged in. I got a real plug, it never let me down.
Always come through when I need it, never been a drought.
Woke up early Sunday, hustling all week. Cook a meal up in that studio and let my dogs eat. Got my mind up on my mission, no time for distractions. I told my partner, pay your taxes before they come get at you. And plus my bro just made parole, yeah, let him go, yeah. Did his time up in that hole, yeah, they hit the road, yeah. In this industry for years, ain't never sold my soul, yeah. Gave him real estate investments instead of buying gold, yeah.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord and good morning. Welcome to our virtual experience this morning. We pray that everything that you hear on this morning will be blessing to your spirit on this morning. We just ask for you to bow your heads and let us have a moment of prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, we adore you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we bless your holy name on this morning. Lord God, knowing that you are the God of hope, you are the God of peace, Lord God, we just ask for you to come into this place, come into this house right now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, for you know each and every one of our needs, Lord God. Lord God, everyone that is watching, Lord God, whether they're in the living room, whether they're in the kitchen, Lord God, we ask you to meet them on this morning, Lord God. Lord God, we worship you. We love you. We bless you. Lord God, we thank you for all the things that you have done, all the things that you are doing, and all the things that you are going to do. Lord God, now we ask you to bless the praise team. Lord God, bless the musicians, Lord God. Bless the man of God that's going to bring forth the word on this morning. Lord God, that we may be able to cry out, what must we do to be saved and get closer to you? Lord God, we just thank you. We thank you, thank you, thank you. We love you and bless you. And that's all these things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
How many know that God is able to do just what he said he was going to do? Exceedingly, abundantly, above all you can ask or think, according to power that worketh in you. When God is able to do just what he said he would do, he's going to fulfill every promise to you. He won't give up on you. He's able. My God is. flow is our. Don't give up on God. Said, don't give up on God. When it didn't go your way, said, don't give up on God. Don't give up on God. When he opened a door and closed another, hallelujah. Say, don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. 'Cause he won't give up on you. Said he's able. Hallelujah.
Grab your tablets, grab your smartphones, grab your Bible, grab whatever you have, and join us in the Word this morning. Share, invite somebody to watch with you as we give you a word from the Lord. Go with us to Nehemiah, the fourth chapter. Nehemiah, the fourth chapter. But when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabs, Ammonites, and Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead and that the gaps in the wall of Jerusalem were being repaired, they were furious. They all made plans to come and fight against Jerusalem and throw us into confusion. But we prayed to our God and guarded the city day and night to protect ourselves. Father, we decrease that you may increase. We step down that you may step up. Speak a word in somebody's life this morning. You know what we all stand in need of. And we trust you. We depend on you. You are our Lord. You are our Savior. And you are our God. Help us to articulate your word with clarity, power, and authority. God, speak a word that somebody's life has changed. Somebody's healed. Somebody's delivered. And somebody's set free on this morning. God, help us to be relevant and informal. It is in that name that is above all names we do all things, Jesus the Christ, and we know that it is so. When Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabs, Ammonites, and Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead and that the gaps in the wall of Jerusalem were being repaired, they were furious. They all made plans to come and fight against Jerusalem and throw us into confusion. But we prayed to our God and guarded the city day and night to protect ourselves. To protect ourselves. This morning, my brothers and sisters, I want to preach from the title of this message, Keep Your Head Up. Keep your head up. The prolific lyrics of Tupac Shakur lingers in my head as he penned these words, we ain't meant to survive, 'cause it's a setup. And even though fed up, huh? You gotta keep your head up. Keep your head up, ooh child. Things are gonna get easier. Ooh child. Things are going to get brighter. Keep your head up, oh child. Things are going to get easier. Keep your head up, oh child, because things will get brighter. Let's be honest and admit that people at times will make you want to quit. Have you ever found yourself in a place dealing with people and you wanted to quit? Have you ever found yourself in a place dealing with people and you wanted to give up? Have you ever found yourself in a place dealing with people and you really wanted to just walk away? Have you ever found yourself in a place dealing with people and saying, I don't know how much more of this I really can take? Have you ever became frustrated with dealing with people? Yeah. You can be honest. You can admit that sometimes they got on your nerves. Yeah. Yeah, sometimes, yeah, they made you upset. Sometimes you understood that they really didn't have your best interests at heart. Have you ever been dealing with somebody and you came to the realization that they really wasn't riding with you? Mm-hmm. Have you ever realized that they really wasn't riding with you? See, you got to understand that sometimes people will discourage you from where God is trying to take you. People will be the main ones that try to talk you out of what God is trying to do in your lives. Yeah, yeah. It would be people that tell you, if that was me, I wouldn't do it that way. If it was me, I wouldn't have handled it like that. If it was me, this is how I would do it, or this is how I would orchestrate it. But you got to be careful of people that have so much advice but don't have the testimony to prove that they've done this before. Yeah, yeah. You got to be careful of people who have so much advice but cannot give you the testimony that will prove that they've done this before. I'm tired of hearing the people tell me of what they have done and they don't have the evidence to show that they've really been there. I don't have time of you telling me how to get out of what I'm in unless you came from where I come from. I don't have time of you telling me how I should come out of this and how I should respond when you've never seen adversity and you've never faced what I'm facing. But I came to encourage somebody this morning that felt like giving up and felt like throwing in the towel, just to tell you, keep your head up. Ooh, child. Things are going to get easier. Yeah, yeah. It's not saying that things will always be good, but they're going to get better. It's not saying that you won't face adversity, but it will get better. But you got to keep your head up. You got to keep your head up even when people come and try to discourage you. People will hit you sometimes as hard, if not as harder, than life will itself. Yeah, people sometimes will be more of a problem than the problems that you face in life itself. Yeah, people sometimes will be, yeah, yeah, more discouraging than what you really faced in life, or those discouraging moments themselves. But you got to be careful of people that does not take and do not take in regards of who you are or what God has called you to be in account and respond to that matter and know how to handle you. Be careful of people that mishandle you in this season. Be careful of people that use you in this season. Be careful of people who try to surround themselves with you in this season. Why? Because if you're not pushing me, then you're pulling me. And I cannot afford to miss God because I got my head down because you discouraged me. Cannot afford to miss God because I got my head down because you told me I couldn't do it. I can't afford to miss God because I got my head down because you said that it was impossible. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There are some people that would tell you that it's impossible for God to do what you are in. Yeah, yeah. It's impossible for God to change the outcome of the circumstances or the situation that you are facing. Yeah, it's people that will try to discourage you and make you feel as if it's hopeless when you serve the God of hope. Yeah, yeah, it's people that will discourage you and make you feel like God cannot pull anything out of the ruins when he's the God that creates out of nothing. You got to be careful of people that try to discredit God of what you know he's already capable of doing. You got to be careful of people that try to make you discredit God of what you already know that he is capable of doing. I don't have time to be scrutinized. I don't have time to be judged. I don't have time for you sizing me up where I'm at now in life. I've already had enough setbacks from life itself than to have to worry if you want to see me win or quit. I've already had enough of heartaches and headaches and pain than to worry about if you're rocking with me only to see if I'm going to fail like how you prayed I would. Yeah, somebody needs to catch that Somebody out there is praying that you fail. Somebody out there is praying that you don't make it. Somebody out there is praying that you don't succeed. Somebody out there is praying that you fall. But let me tell you something. You can't waste time surrounding yourself with people that don't believe that you're coming out of this. You got to keep your head up, even if you got to separate yourself from the distractions that may be in your circle. You got to keep your head up, even if you got to pull yourself out of relationships that never had your best interest in the first place. You got to understand that you got to be careful of people who only celebrate you while in front of you. You got to be careful of people who only celebrate you while in front of you. You know, I want to give you applause when I'm in front of you. I want to tell you that I always knew that you could do it when I'm in front of you. I want to tell you that it's going to be all right when I'm in front of you. But at the moment I leave you, I said, I don't know how in the world they're going to get it done. I don't know how in the world they're going to come out of this one. I don't know how in the world this is going to turn around. Why? Because people will find it convenient only to celebrate you when they're in front of you. But let me tell you something. I need a group of people or a team that's surrounding me that's capable of celebrating me even when they can't see or understand how the vision will be fulfilled. I don't know how God's going to do it, but if you said that he can, I'm crazy enough to believe with you that he's capable of doing anything. I need a group of people like that, that if I have faith, then you have 10 times the faith to say that I can believe God to do the impossible. You just got to keep your head up. I need the type of people that are in my circle that when my head is falling, they're willing to hold it up and say, don't lose focus on what God has promised you, because if he said it, then he's capable of fulfilling what he said. Keep your head up, girl. Keep your head up, man. Keep your head up, children. Whoever it is, you got to have somebody that's willing to celebrate you, not only when they're in front of you. You got to have somebody that's willing to celebrate you, not only when they're in front of you, but when they're behind closed doors. You don't have to question what they believe or what they will say. You got to be careful if you can't trust your circle to say the same thing you say when they're out of your presence. Yeah, somebody needs to catch that. See, a lot of times we put faith and trust in those that really don't believe in what God has promised us. So when they leave you, they're talking another game. When they leave you, they got a whole different tune. When they leave you, they're saying, yeah, they must be crazy. I don't know how it's going to happen. Oh yeah, they must be crazy. Yeah, have you seen how it looked? Have you seen the results of it? Yeah, they say it's impossible to come back from this one. I need some people that when they leave me, they're on their knees and they're praying and they're casting down every negative word and saying, I don't care how it looks. If God says he's going to change it, then I'm crazy enough to say that he's going to change it. I need the type of people that's telling me that, listen, I know that they don't believe that God is capable, but if you can say it, then I believe in praying that he's able to manifest exactly what he has promised. But I don't need nobody that's celebrating me just to be in front of me. I don't need nobody to be praising and thankful just because you're in front of me. I don't need nobody just to be saying, I knew you were going to do a good job because you're in front of me. Be careful of the applauses that you get only because of the stage that you've created. Because people will come to applaud you after they see what God has done, when all along they never believed that God was going to do it. So because they have the opportunity to applaud you on a stage is the only reason they showed up. But I need some people to show up when I'm in the roughest places. I need some people to show up even when I'm in the roughest area. I need some people to show up even when I'm in the middle of my desert. I need some people to show up even when I'm in the middle of my wreckage. I need some people to show up even when I'm in the middle of not having my mind all together. I need some people to show up even when I'm in the middle of not having all my thoughts together. I need some people that will show up even when I don't have my whole self together and say, listen, you got to pick your head up, because he that has begun a good work in you, he is God enough that he's willing and able to complete what he started. Get your head up. Get your head in the game. Get yourself out of the rut. Get yourself out of the place of lying dormant and complacent, because God is able to do it. Keep your head up. It is those who never believed in you or really desire for you to win. Watch out for the ones who never believed you could get anything accomplished without them. Yeah, you got to watch out for the ones that believe that you could never get anything accomplished without them. You got to be careful of the ones that feel as if, oh, in order for you to make it, you need me. Yeah, you got to be careful of the ones that live in a place to say, hey, listen, the only way you can get it is if I give you the approval or I put my stamp on it. You got to be careful of the ones that feel like God is going to approve what he's going to do based off of how they feel. Yeah, you got to be careful of the ones that make you feel as if God is going to say what he's going to say based off of how they respond to him. Be careful of the ones that feel as if you need them in order to go next. Because some people will make you think that the only reason you can go to your next is because you have them now. Yeah, some people will make you think that the only reason that you can go from where you are to where God is trying to take you if you have the connection with me. But be careful of those people that are so into themselves, that are so self-centered, yeah, that are so arrogant and prideful. Yeah, that they can say that it's because of me that you're where you are. Because let me tell you something. God is the type of God that he will remove anything that would try to get glory of what he's established. Yeah. So when he takes them away, don't question what he's doing. Just praise him, because you got to understand that he's removing every hindrance. He's removing every stumbling block. He's removing every blockage so that you can embrace the moment that he's getting ready to take you in. But you got to keep your head up. People have the tendency to believe that the only way you can be successful is if they have a hand in what you're doing. You know what? If you give me the information, I can make more sales than you. If you send me the information, I can refer more people than you. Yeah. But I got breaking news. And that is the only one that I need in my plan of succession is God. Yeah, God is the only one that I need in order to be successful. God is the only one that I need in order to get what I'm going to get. God is the only one I need in order to have what I'm going to have. God is the only one that I need in order to step into the next place that I'm going to step in. Why? Because it's him that gives promotion. It doesn't come from the east. It doesn't come from the north. It doesn't come from the south. It doesn't come from the west. But all that I need, it comes from God, because he is the supplier of all of my needs. So you got to be careful of people that make you feel like your success is based off if they're connected to you or they're not. You gotta understand that the only one I need to win in life and is the key ingredient is God. If you have God, yeah, he'll connect you to all the right people. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can stand against us? If God is for us, who can stand against us? But you got to watch out for the ones who stand back to congratulate you once the work is completed, but did not assist when it was time to get it done. You know how it worked. Oh, we did such a good job. You know what? Yeah. Oh, it looks so beautiful. Oh, yeah. You know how I say we put all our work in. I remember those tiresome nights. Yeah, I remember those sleep. Moments we put all this work in and look what we got done. No, you didn't do a thing, but it was God that gave me the ability to do what I've done. So I stopped by to encourage three of you that are watching this live to don't allow what they think stop you from getting done what God has said. Keep your head up. Can I tell you that some people don't need your money? They don't need your word. They just need your words. Some people don't need your resources, but they need your encouragement. Not because I lack momentum. It's not because I'm slack or I'm slowful or lack momentum, but because I understand that every human being needs human interaction. Yeah. Every human being needs human interaction. Well, what are you saying, Pastor Tim? Then the Lord. God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. In other words, I will give him the opportunity to interact with something that understands him. A helper, another human. He says, I need you to understand that it's not because they're discouraged. It's not because they don't have momentum, but sometimes in this human body, we need human interaction. We need somebody that looks like us. We need somebody that sounds like us. I don't need your money. I just need your encouragement to tell me when I want to quit, when I want to give up, when I want to walk away. Keep your head up. Put your head in the game. Don't allow what has happened distract you from what God has said. Because if God has said it, then he's capable of fulfilling what he said. But you got to have a human interaction in order to grasp that sometimes. You got to have human interaction in order to see that sometimes. But he says, listen, you got to understand that it's because of me and because of what I'm doing and what I'm trying to manifest in order for you to see this. You got to be careful of the interactions that you have. Yeah. But let me just say this. Just because they are human doesn't mean that they are God's sent. Just because they are human doesn't mean that they are God sent. Just because they came in the nick of time doesn't mean that he dropped them on you. Yeah. Just because they showed up when you were in the worst state and in the worstest moment doesn't mean that God orchestrated them to fall in place in your life. Yeah, you got to be careful because sometimes the enemy will send watchers to make sure that you're not successful in what you're trying to do. Yeah, sometimes the enemy will send watchers to make sure that you're unsuccessful in what God has promised you. But when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabs, Ammonites and Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead, hold on, what are you saying, Pastor Tim? When they got the news that they could not stop what God was getting ready to do, then they got angry. Can I tell you that some people will become upset when they cannot stop what God has performed in your life? Somebody needs to catch that. Some people will get angry because every prayer they prayed did not succeed and God still manifested what he's promised over you. Well, can I tell you something? Your bad news is not my bad news. And your bad news can never stop what God has spoken over my life. Why? Because you may have a prayer, but I have his. word, and his word shall not return to him void, but it shall accomplish everything that he sent it out to do. So what are you saying, Pastor Tim? Let them pray to the devil, but let God manifest and show them that he's God. And as long as God is God, there is no power in hell, there is no power in the earth that can take hold of what God has promised, or neither hinder or stop it. No, they can't stop it. Yeah, they thought they could stop you by now. But can I tell you something? If they could have stopped you by now, don't you think that you would have already been stopped? Yeah, yeah. If they could hinder you by now, don't you think by now you would have already been hindered? But the Bible says here in Nehemiah begins to write. He says, we're trying to get something done. But every time we find ourselves moving ahead, here comes that O.N. me. He comes to stop us. Every time we find ourselves trying to establish, here comes the enemy. Because just like the enemy, he only shows up when you're making progress. Yeah. The enemy only shows up when you're making progress. If you ain't getting nothing done, he don't have a reason to show up. If you ain't getting nothing done, he don't have a reason to poke his head out. But the Bible says that, but when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabs and the Ammonites and the Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead and that the gaps in the wall of Jerusalem were being repaired. Hold on. You mean to tell me they didn't need our help in order to get this done? Yeah, they made jokes. Yeah, they made funny mockeries. Yeah, if you go further on in the text, before you get down here, it says that they were laughing and they were picking at the Israelites. They say, who do they think they are? Do they not understand that in the rubbish, there is nothing left to rebuild? Well, let me tell you something. I came to speak to somebody this morning and prophetically speak and tell you that God can build out of your rubbish. I don't care how it looks. I don't care how it feels. He will take that nothing that they said could not establish, and he will bring the most beautifulest thing out of your ashes. God will take your nothing and create a masterpiece. But he says you got to learn not to allow what they say make you forget about what he has promised. Keep your head up. Keep your head up, because somebody's standing by watching and saying it's impossible for them to get something out of the rubbish. Yeah, it's impossible for them to succeed when there's nothing to even build on. So the Bible says that Sanballat and Tobiah, yeah, they were picking and they were making a mockery. They were saying it's impossible for anything to come out of the rubbish. Who do they think they are? I know that they've gathered together, but can you tell me, will you rebuild the wall in one day? Will you be able to reestablish what has been destroyed in one day? Well, let me tell you something. I may not do it in one day, but you will never stop me from doing what God has said. Because it may not be one day, but what I can promise you, that when he establishes it, it will be hell proof. Why? Because there is nothing in the earth. There is nothing under the earth. There is nothing that the gates of hell can prevent against this. If I have what God has said and I keep my head up, then I'm capable of holding up in the midst of my rubbish. I'm capable of being sustained in the middle of the mess. I'm capable of coming out with something good out of this mess. You need to tell somebody something good is coming out of the mess. Yeah, yeah. Something good is coming out of this mess. I don't care how it looks now. Something good's coming out of this. I don't care how it feels now. Something good is coming out of this. So the Bible says that San Sanballat and Tobiah and the rest of the enemies. Say, who do they think they are that they are continuing to build the wall out of the mess? Yeah, but when they saw, because sometimes the only evidence you have is the sight of a thing. Sometimes the only evidence you have is when they see that God is doing exactly what he said. There is nothing that gets under the enemy's skin more than him seeing God manifesting what he said. After they spoke the lies, after they said you will never be nothing, after they said you will never come out, after they said you will never make it, after they said you will never amount to anything, after they set up, after they have plotted, after they have schemed, after they have lied, he still says, I will cause the very things that they said to be the very building blocks to build a wall to keep them out. But you got to keep your head up. You got to keep your head up. He never said that it wouldn't come, but he says it wouldn't stop you. He never said that it wouldn't happen, but he says that it wouldn't hold you back. So after they saw that their work continued, but that wasn't the problem, but after they saw the wall gaps were beginning to close in, every way that they could come in, there's nothing worse. They can't come in that way no more. The things that used to affect you is the things that they can't use anymore to be the thing that affect you. The very tactics that they used to try to stop you are not the tactics anymore that they can use to stop you. So it says that he saw that the work was being completed. He saw that God was establishing it. He saw that the very thing that they were working against wasn't working for them. And the walls were closing in. I came to tell somebody the last way that the enemy attacked you, it won't work this time because the walls are closing in. The last tactics that he used the last time to discourage you, they're not going to work in this season because the walls are closing in. The response that he expected to get and the attitude that he expected to adjust to, let me tell him, it's not going to work this time because the walls are closing in. So they see that the walls of Jerusalem were being repaired and the gaps are closing in, and they became furious. They became upset because, you know, anytime the enemy can't get his way, he becomes upset because it's not happening how he said it would. When he has to go back to the drawing board and come up with something else to attack you, he gets upset because I thought that it would work through their children, but they still got their head up. I thought it would work through their family, but they still keeping their head up. I thought that it would work through their loved ones, through their spouses, but they still keeping their head up. I thought that it would work through their relationships, but they still keeping their head up. So they became furious. And when they became furious, they all made plans to come and fight against Jerusalem and throw them into confusion. Why? Because the first thing the enemy does when he knows that he can't touch you, he tries to confuse you. The first thing the enemy does when he knows that he can't get to you the way that he used to, he tries to confuse you. Why does he try to confuse you? Because the Bible says that a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. So he understands that if he can confuse you, then he can distract you. And if he can distract you, then he can weaken you. And if he can weaken you, then he can conquer you. But let me tell you something, that when he tries to confuse you, keep your head up. Keep your head up and be careful of the Sanballats that come in the form of friends. Be careful of the Sanballats that comes in the form of friends. Be careful of the Sanballats that comes in the form of friends, because Sanballat means enemy in secret. Yeah, somebody needs to catch that. Sanballat means enemy in secret. So be careful of the Sanballats that try to come in your life in the form of friends. I know where you are. Oh, I know where you at, girl. Oh, I've been there before. Oh, yeah, you can tell me anything. Yeah, I promise you, I'm going to ride with you. You got to be careful of the Sanballats that come in the form of friends when they're the ones that's plotting against you, when they're the ones that's running your plans, when they're the ones that's running your vision, because their desire is to see you fail. But keep your head up and keep your eyes open and be vigilant and be prayerful and be watchful, because Sanballats is coming. But when you understand the plans of the enemy, you understand they can't stop you. It can become disheartening when you don't know who's around that you can trust. It becomes disheartening when you have people around you and you don't know if they have your best interest at heart. But you got to be careful of the Sanballats. You can't afford to allow anyone in this circle. You cannot afford to allow anyone in your closest space. Yeah, you can't afford to allow anyone, to take resident over where they just supposed to be spending the night at. Yeah, see, sometimes we make things more permanent when it should be temporary. Yeah, we take a temporary situation and we try to make it permanent. But the Bible says that Nehemiah, they worked on the wall. Yeah, and as they worked on the wall, here comes the enemy. He was trying to destroy what God told them to establish. He was trying to destroy what God told them to do. Because let me tell you something, when God gives you a word, it's going to be the enemy that brings the first accusation and tries to stop you. Yeah, when God gives you a word, it's going to be the enemy that comes to you first and say, does God really want you to do this? Well, can I tell you something? The devil is not going to give you good instructions. No, the devil is not going to tell you the good advice of what God is going to do. If he tells you anything, yeah, it will be jaded. Yeah, it will be manipulated. Yeah, it will be in a place of untruth, because the devil cannot tell the truth, because he is a liar and he is the father of all lies. So let me tell you something, that when you have somebody that's coming, that's trying to make you trust them, run. When you have somebody that's coming and trying to win your trust, run. Why? Because a friend doesn't have to prove to you that they're a friend. They'll just be a friend. Yeah. A friend doesn't have to come to make you feel like they're trying to earn you. They will just be who they are. Because at the end of the day, Sanballat, he comes as a secret enemy. So what are you saying, Pastor Tim? There has been a time when he had to be smiling in their face. Yeah, there had to be a time when he was encouraging me. Yeah, it had to be a time when he was telling him, yeah, you can do it. But at the moment you make your own decisions is the moment it will show you exactly how they feel about you. At the moment you have a disagreement, it will be the moment that they say, we really ain't riding together. So be careful of the Sanballats, because it will be the secret enemies that tells about what you came from and what you did. Be careful of the enemies in secret that try to destroy you publicly. Be careful of the enemies in secret that tries to destroy you publicly, because Sanballat is a sign of trying to destroy you publicly. Why in the world would I be a secret enemy? Because I can know the secret things. If I'm a secret enemy, then I can know exactly where you stand. I can know exactly how you move. I can know exactly what your plans are. So you gotta be careful of the Sanballats that comes as secret enemies in order to know what your name next move is. So the Bible says that Nehemiah continues to build the wall, but they said to themselves, yeah, Sanballat and Tobias and the rest of the enemies, they said, let's attack them right where they are. Let's stop the process. Let's stop the progress. Let's stop what they're trying to do, because if they build the wall, it's going to be devastating, because we won't be able to move how we've been moving. Yeah, you got to build a wall sometimes so that people will understand that they just don't have access to you just like that. There are some people in your life that you got to create an exit for and don't allow them back in. Why? Because everyone does not deserve the access that you have been giving them. You got to be careful, because there's a secret enemy waiting to see and expose you publicly. Build that wall. Why? Because you can't afford to miss God because of them. I know it's disheartening because you don't know who you can trust, but God sent me here this morning to tell you, don't allow disloyal people make you doubt his loyalty. Don't allow disloyal people to make you doubt his loyalty. Keep your head up. Success doesn't always come easy, but it will be well worth the work. Yeah, it'll be well worth the work. Yeah, it's going to be exactly what you need it to be. But in order to see it, you got to keep your head up. It's impossible to see if your head is down. You can't see what's in front of you if your head is down. You can't see what God is trying to do if your head is down. We got to understand that people will walk away, but keep your head up. Friends will dishonor you. Keep your head up. Relationships will end, but keep your head up. Some people aren't looking or expecting you to survive because it's a setup. Even though you're fed up, you got to keep your head up. Keep your head up. Ooh, child. Things are going to get easier. Keep your head up. Ooh, child. Things are going to get brighter. Ooh, child. Keep your head up. Things are going to get easier. Keep your head up. Ooh, child. Things will get brighter. Sanballat and Tobiah and the rest of the enemies were expecting Nehemiah to fail at rebuilding the wall. But prayers sustained them in the presence of their enemies. And thou shalt prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Don't allow their talking to stop you from building. Work on and keep your head up. Because the Bible says that because Nehemiah kept his head up and they prayed to God, scripture says they watched, prayed, and kept their weapons in their hands. So they build with one hand, and they had their weapon in the other. Why? Because this is not the place or the season to become comfortable. This is not the place or the season to become lax. But you got to keep your head up. You cannot allow what they think or how they feel stop you from doing what you've always knew how to do. Pray and work. My greatest testimony is going to be in the success of me completing the work But in order not to become distracted by what they say, you must remain focused on who you know, Jesus. God will sometimes hold your head up in the front of those who broke you. Yeah, they didn't believe it could happen. But even when I felt like quitting, I can admit there were times that he held my head up until I got myself together and I could continue the work. Keep your head up. It's not for the bragging rights, but it's for you to complete what he told you to do. Keep your head up. Ooh, child. Things are going to get easier. Ooh, child. Things are going to get brighter. I pray this morning that someone that heard this word continues to build the wall. Forget the distractions. Zone out every negative word and the negative people so that you can take hold of what God has promised you to do and has promised you could have. I'm here to pray for someone that doesn't know Jesus and the pardon of their sins. Someone that doesn't know him as their Lord and Savior. Jesus, come into my life. I'm a sinner. I need you. I believe that you came from heaven into the earth. From the earth to the cross, you carried my sins. But from the cross to the grave, you died for me. But you got up on the third day with all power in your hands. You ascended into heaven and sat on the right hand of our Father. And there you're waiting for his command for your return, for your bridegroom. I confess with my mouth, but I believe in my heart that you rose from the dead, that you are my Lord and Savior, and my soon and coming King. I pray that God keeps you. Thank you for giving. You can give by Cash App, $SourceChurchSC, Cash App, $SourceChurchSC. But you can also give by the link under the Source Church Facebook page, Give Online. Yeah. If you don't have a church on, we're here to invite you to join the family. The doors are open. I know that it's virtual, but formally we would do it when we come back together. We look forward to seeing your face in the place. If you desire prayer, we're here to pray for you. Whatever you need, we're here for you. Thank you for partnering with us in your giving. It does not go unnoticed. We appreciate everything that you do. And because of your giving, because of your tithing, because of your time, we're capable and able to do ministry the way that we do it. And we say thank you. We love you. And I'm praying that this week be a great and successful week, as this day has been declared a great and successful day. I pray that God keeps you, cover you, and protect you throughout this week. Listen, keep your head up. I know that life sometimes can be discouraging. Sometimes you want to quit and give up. But I dare everyone and challenge everyone that's watching this live. Share it. Invite somebody to watch it so that they can be encouraged to tag somebody so that they'll know that even in the midst of an uncertain world, we serve a certain God that's guaranteed to fulfill every promise. Keep your head up. Keep your head up now. I know it's not grammatically correct, but listen, sometimes you got to take it back to the street. Keep your head up. Put your head back in the game. I'm Pastor Tim, and we are the Source Church. I pray that God bless you and continue to manifest yourself in your life. Until next time, stay safe, be encouraged, and know that we love you. God bless you.